Greetings. In this video, I continue to discuss verses which appear to refute the rapture. In this video, I would like to discuss John 17:15. John 17:15, Christ prayed not for us to be taken out of the world, but for us to be kept from the evil one, the Antichrist. Why would he pray such a prayer if we are going to be raptured before the tribulation even begins? I think that is a great question. However, it may arise from several misunderstandings. Let's read the verse first, and then a little later include some clarifying context. John 17:15, I pray not that thou, or God, take them out of the world, but that you, God, should keep them from the evil one. I think it is indeed tempting to associate take them out of the world with the rapture. But I find this verse less clear regarding its association to the end times than Luke 21:36. Be watching at all times, therefore, and praying that you will be worthy to escape from these things which are going to occur and to stand before the Son of Man. And there is certainly room for discussion. In John 17, Jesus is praying and praying for believers. In Luke 21, Jesus is telling us how and what to pray for. That is just one aspect to consider. But does it even make a difference? In John 17, Jesus mentions out of the world. In Luke 21, Jesus speaks of specific events to avoid. While they seem similar, the two strike me as fundamentally different. I would categorize the importance of this point as minor, however. A second point as I read this verse, I do not believe the evil one means the Antichrist. Certainly the Antichrist will be evil. He gets his motivation from the dragon. In the scriptures, Satan or the devil would rightly deserve the title the evil one. Honestly, I do not find the rationale I just gave compelling or conclusive, but there is something in the context which provides more indication the evil one is not the Antichrist. John 17:20. My prayer is not for them alone. I pray also for those who will believe in me through their message. In this verse, Jesus expands the list of who he is praying for. Specifically, he adds those who believe through the message. That pretty clearly identifies everyone who believes later. It also separates those who heard Jesus directly. That means Jesus is not praying only for the Christians of the last day. Jesus is not praying for only Christians susceptible to the Antichrist or the tribulation. It would make no sense for Jesus to pray for 2,000 years for Christians at no risk from the Antichrist. But all Christians who ever lived have been at risk to Satan's or the devil's attack. 1 Peter 5:8, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walks about seeking whom he may devour. This is constant. I pray not that you should take them out of the world, but that you should keep them from the evil one. We know Jesus here is praying for his living disciples. So an additional question is, does taking them out of the world mean the rapture? I don't really think so. Here, Jesus' prayer implies more regarding the fate of his disciples. Jesus is leaving. Jesus knows he is leaving. John 14:3, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may also be. John 13:33, little children, I'm with you only a little longer. You will look for me, but what I told the Jewish leaders, I now tell you, where I'm going, you cannot come. John 13:36, Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, where are you going?" And Jesus answered, "Where I go, you cannot follow me now, but you will follow later." Jesus is leaving. Jesus knows he is leaving. And he knows the fate of his disciples. He has tried to prepare them. John 14:27, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid." John 15:18, "If the world hates you, you know that it hated me before it hated you." John 16:33, "These things I have spoken to you, so that in me you may have peace. In the world you have tribulation, but take courage, I have overcome the world." Matthew 24:9, "Then you will be handed over to be persecuted and put to death, and you will be hated by all nations because of me." I believe Jesus could have spared them their tribulations, just as Jesus had to choose to die on the cross. Luke 22:42, "And he said, Father, if you are willing, let this cup pass from me. However, not my will, but yours be done." I can imagine Jesus explicitly prayed to leave his friends and brothers behind. Knowledge can be a scary and burdensome thing. John 16:2, "You will be thrown out of synagogues. Certainly, the time is coming when people who murder you will think that they are serving God." Jesus knew the fate of his disciples. Pause and reflect on the love Jesus had for the men he walked with. Luke 22:31, "And the Lord said, Simon, Simon, behold, Satan has desired to have you, that he may sift you as wheat. But I have prayed for you, Simon, that your faith may not fail. When you have turned back, strengthen your brothers." Luke 21:36, "Be watching at all times, therefore, and praying that you will be worthy to escape from these things which are going to occur, and to stand before the Son of Man." Jesus says, "these things." He means the things that he just got through describing. Luke 21:7 onward parallels Matthew 24, describing the end times. Luke 21:34, "Be on guard, so that your hearts will not be weighed down with dissipation and drunkenness and the worries of life, and that day will not come on you suddenly like a trap. For it will come upon all those who dwell on the face of all the earth. But keep on the alert at all times, praying that you may have strength to escape all these things that are about to take place, and to stand before the Son of Man." You pray that you may escape. You pray. John 17:15, "Christ prayed not for us to be taken out of the world, but for us to be kept from the evil one, the Antichrist." Why would he pray such a prayer if we are going to be raptured before the tribulation even begins? Basically, in summary, I do not think John 17:15 means the Antichrist, and also does not refer to the rapture, or even the end times or last days. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.